What is up, you guys? Welcome back to another one. If you are new to the channel, I am Gold Pony. Today we are in Stegosaurus, aka my 2019 Ford Mustang GT. And so I purchased this thing about a year and a half ago at this point, and plenty of people have asked me already, has it been reliable for you? So I figured I would address that in a video in case you were considering purchasing a Mustang, whether it be a new or a used Mustang. I wanted to cover all of that in this video. And so today I wanted to pick a scenic little drive for you guys through the Appalachian Mountains here in Pennsylvania. And we are going to go over if the Ford Mustang actually is a reliable car. And so of course there are plenty of things that will factor into this equation. First thing of course to consider is going to be the year of the Ford Mustang. You can imagine different years are going to have different reliability for different reasons. So when you actually go to take a look at the year of a Ford Mustang to determine if it's reliable, the source that I typically go by is Consumer Reports. The reason being is because they are one of the very few, if not the only organization out there that predicts and rates reliability based off the vehicles that they actually purchase, and they do take no money from any manufacturer, so therefore they are a completely independent organization, and so therefore they are going to be a little more trustworthy than some of the other ones out there. And so what I am going to do here is I'm going to take a picture of my Consumer Reports magazine I recently purchased to give you guys a little bit of an idea of which particular years have been reliable, and this is the most up-to-date magazine that they've put out, at least at the time of this video, I should say. But the way the rating system actually works is red is going to signify well below average, orange is going to be below average, yellow is average, a light green is going to be above average, and then a dark green is going to be well above average. And so as you guys can see there, there have been only 3 years so far that have been rated above average, being 2011, 2012, and the current one I'm in today, the 2019 Ford Mustang. So that is one of the ways to go ahead and guess the Ford Mustang reliability when it comes to the years at least. And so if you were thinking about purchasing a Ford Mustang, go ahead and check out Consumer Reports. They're going to essentially let you know what the issues were, if any, and what years are going to be the most reliable for you. So having said that, there are of course other factors to consider when purchasing a Ford Mustang or when gauging the reliability, one of them being the engine as well. And so throughout the years, Mustang has put out plenty of different engine setups. More recently, starting in the 2015 model year, they've had three, being the naturally aspirated V6, the turbocharged inline four-cylinder, aka the EcoBoost engine, and the naturally aspirated V8 found in the Mustang GT, which is currently what I'm driving. And so the basic rule of thumb when it comes to those particular engine configurations is the naturally aspirated ones are found to be a little bit more reliable than the turbocharged engines. And there's plenty of reasons for that, and really that applies to all engines out there, regardless of manufacturers. But I will say, a lot of the turbocharged engines have become a lot more reliable in recent years. Take for instance Hyundai. They have some extremely reliable turbocharged engines. Just take a look at Consumer Reports when it comes to them. But essentially what I'm getting at here, for point of reference, if you go to autotrader.com and you look up the pre-owned Ford Mustangs, the ones with the most mileage on them right now are going to be the naturally aspirated engine setups, whether it be the NA 6-cylinder or the 8-cylinder found in the GT. Those are the ones that you are going to find with 200,000 plus miles on it, even 300,000 plus miles on it, believe it or not. So if you want a reliable Mustang, I would definitely point you in the direction of one of those two engine setups, as opposed to the EcoBoost engine. Not that that one can't be reliable, because really any vehicle can be reliable if you take care of it well. And so that's my next point here with the Mustang. A lot of it comes down to as well how you drive it. And so if you're planning on buying a Ford Mustang, a used Ford Mustang, definitely take a look at the maintenance records. You want to make sure that the oil changes have been regular, everything has been kept up to date, or at very minimum, have a trusted local mechanic take a full inspection, take a full look at it before you go and actually buy the thing, because you want to make sure it was definitely taken care of and there's no hidden surprises when you go to actually get it, of course. Also, another thing to consider, if you can at least, and this doesn't apply to all situations, I will say that, but if the previous owner was a little bit older in age, you could probably assume that they didn't drive it like an 18-year-old would. And so with the Ford Mustang being a sports car and a very enjoyable car to drive, a lot of them will be driven like they were meant to, essentially. So that is, of course, yet another thing you want to look out for. But in most cases, I would say it's safe to assume the higher up in age the previous owner is, the safer bet you probably have on purchasing that car, because they're not going to beat it as hard as an 18-year-old otherwise would. So another thing to consider there. Also, something that might hurt the reliability as expected is the modifications, depending upon the modifications that the previous owner had put on the Mustang. And the reason why I say depending, not all modifications will harm car may vehicle. For instance, some of the things I would probably look out for, obviously, are tuned cars. That is something I would definitely stay away from. Also, supercharged cars, aftermarket superchargers, I will say, and aftermarket turbochargers. Because the thing with them is they tend to add so much horsepower, but typically the owners don't take into account other things that may have to be upgraded along with those turbo or superchargers, like the transmission, for instance, like the drive shaft. So if they drive their Mustang GT hard with 700 plus horsepower, a lot of times what'll end up happening, and I've heard stories from dealerships, from mechanics, and from other modified Mustang owners, what then ends up happening is the transmission will fail or the drive shaft will fail because those two components weren't meant to handle 700 plus horsepower. They were meant to handle the 460 that it came with from the factory. So another thing to consider when it comes to modifications, at least there. And actually, a quick little story since we're on the topic of modifications. I previously put a cold air intake on one of my previous cars, not the Ford Mustang, but an Acura RSX. What ended up happening was because of the placement of the intake when it rained out, whenever it rained out really, the intake had a tendency to pull in some water, hydro-locking the engine, unfortunately. So that is yet another thing you want to consider. And so ultimately, I guess to answer the question, is a Ford Mustang reliable? Most definitely, yes, it can be. All you really need to do is make sure you do your homework when you go to buy a Ford Mustang. If you're buying a new one, you really don't have to worry about any of your homework there. But when it comes to buying a used one, definitely look into the maintenance records, who owned it previously, things like that. Also, treat it right when you actually do get your Ford Mustang. Because yeah, you can get on it a little bit from time to time, but if you treat your Ford Mustang right, it's gonna treat you right, and it can possibly last 200,000 plus miles, like these other ones I had pulled up here on Auto Trader. So can a Mustang last? Is it reliable? Just like any car, yes. According to Consumer Reports, according to what I found on Auto Trader, most definitely yes, a Ford Mustang can definitely be a reliable vehicle. So that is about it for this one, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to follow me on social media at the bottom of the screen there if you like. Be sure to hit the subscribe and the bell notification button if you're into new car reviews and videos like this, since the whole state of PA is shut down right now. Do appreciate you guys watching more than you know, and I will see you guys all in the next video. Stay gold.